Well, we're pleased to be joined by Michael Andersen, who is the COO for Arcane Tinmen, longtime trading card game supplier for the Dragon Shield line, which is an extremely popular and reputable line of supply products. And they've recently partnered with Beckett to introduce a line of sports collectible supplies to the market under the Beckett Shield brand. Michael, thanks for taking a few minutes out of your day to join us. How are you?
Sure, thanks. I'm very well. Thank you. How about you?
I'm doing well. Thank you very much. Michael's joining us all the way from Denmark via the magic of the internet. So how cool is that? So let's dive right in and get an understanding of what formed this relationship with Arcane Tinmen and Beckett.
Yeah, it all goes back. I think it's 4 years back. Our company was actually sold. We were doing very well, and we were bought by an American capital fund, which also happened to own Beckett. And in that way, we got the connection, and we started visiting these guys, hearing about the sports side. We were doing great on TCG side. We were known for our high quality, and we were talking about how can we bring this into the sports market. And of course, with Beckett, who have all these touch points in the market, know about what it is that is needed from the collectors, we simply started interviewing them and asking, how can we improve these products? What can we do different than what always already is known in the market? And what you will see here in the first round of our new line called Beckett Shield is basic products where we talk with the guys from Beckett about what do you need. And it's typical, the sleeves, the top loaders, the card armor, and so on. But eventually, we will also do innovating stuff that bring freshness into the market.
You know, you touched just briefly on a little bit of research and development, and that's one of the things that I'm most intrigued about. What is that process like from, you know, drawing board to actual distribution? How long was the process of researching the products to bring to market, and what conversations did you have with Beckett to help that development process?
So the project initially started 2 years back, where we say we need to do something because we have the know-how in supplies and they have the know-how in the sports market. We need to bring these things together. And we slowly started with the Dragon Shield and our Tinmen already existing business. We have our distribution center based in Dallas, where Beckett is also at. So our warehouse is really well connected with them, and we have the same workers in the warehouse as Beckett. So the development of the product take, I would say, a year. From start till you have a product with sampling, back and forth, quality test, getting it in the hands of graders. That's been a key element for us, that every grader have had this product in their hand and said, hey, this is something I would use moving forward. And that was very keen for us, that at least these guys who are familiar and handle over 500 to 1,000 cards every single day can nod to these product and sell them with the dignity in their mind.
Obviously, you're well aware of some of the supply chain issues that your competitors are facing in the market. How is Arcane Tinmen and Beckett Shield able to overcome some of those aspects to bring these products to market quickly?
So there are two elements in that. That's also been a key factor for us. So we have chosen that we want to get our product produced close to the core market, and the core market is USA and Canada. So we will get our products produced in North America. It can be either, it would be spread across the North American market. That means our lead time would be maximum 2 weeks if we have production products available at the manufacturing site. Other than that, we have a 20,000 foot square foot warehouse established in Dallas that we anticipate to fill up with all these products.
I know that solicitations for the first wave of products are going out this week. The real question that I'm sure collectors have is, when can they expect to see these on the shelves of their local card shop?
Yeah, well, first wave, first line of product, which would be the sleeve product, will come in at the end of September, and there will be a turnaround quite fast, both from our side and our distributor side with GTS as partners. So hopefully they'll be out in stores first week of October. And after that, we will simply just release products as soon as we get them in our warehouse. We will get some products in the first week of October. I think there will be four small releases during October until we have what we call the core elements of product that is needed for collectors.
One of the things I noticed when this was solicited was some of the unique packaging that you guys have incorporated. A lot of times you go to a retailer and, for example, the top loaders or the one touches are just kind of stacked up on a shelf, if you will. But it seems that you guys have incorporated packaging that they actually sit in a display tray, making it highly visible and easier to organize for store owners. Where did that input come from? Was that internal, external, a little bit of both?
I think that's internal, because that's how we always have looked at it with the Dragon Shield mindset, is how does our product present them best at the retail level, and how can we help the retailer display our products in the best format possible? So that's definitely is a mindset we have on the Dragon Shield that we have taken over to the Beckett Shield also.
You guys have made the smart decision in the SKUs you've rolled out. And just to remind collectors, we've got you've got coming from Beckett Shield top loaders ranging from 35 point to 130 point. You've got your traditional penny sleeves, team bags, resealable graded card sleeves or bags, as well as a 35 point, what you're calling card armor, which has in the past been sealed with a magnetic, although you guys are coming to market with a slightly different design. Can you tell us about that?
Sure, definitely. Yeah, we looked at the magnet and we found one faulty about that product is if you walk in your hall and you drop that case, it will actually pop open because the magnet is not strong enough to keep these two pieces together. So we actually built one with a tab. And the initial thought you will get, the tab will break off. So we went back to our manufacturer and say, we need somehow a tab that is unbreakable. And they actually come back and develop a quite cool item for us where you actually have a tab that cannot break off. And that actually protect your cards even better, because if you drop it from a good amount of height, it will not pop open. It will stay closed, it will stay sealed, it will protect your cards in a better format. And we also did some slightly improvements on the bottom so it can actually stand on it its own. It does not need any case to hold it or anything like that.
Oh, that's really cool. I know that's something that'll be appreciated by a lot of people. Instead of having to buy a separate piece to display, it displays on its own. I'm sure after hearing this, our viewers are wondering, okay, 35 points, great, but I have thicker cards. When can I expect to see card armor in thicker stocks?
So the thick one will be available late November and December. They will be added on as soon as we ensure we have supplies enough to meet the demand in the market on the 35 point, we will add the other ones also. And we expect to have that taken care of in the first month.
All right. So I'm a kind of an analytical person, so let's get a little bit nerdy. Can you explain to us the process of designing and then what goes into making the die that then a mold is made and things like that? I find that whole process very, very interesting.
Yep. So just 1 second. The whole thing started with, of course, an idea of what it is you want to create and what it is you want to build. We have three designers here at Arcane Tinmen, and we give them that idea. They come with the idea. They start doing some 3D rendering. And slowly we start targeting who should be the manufacturer of these. Then we go out and source the market, see who is able of producing something like this, or who have done work in similar materials like this. Then we will go in and do NDA with them, and we will send them the drawings and say, hey, sample this up. Then we will get the samples back and forth, the probably three times we will get samples. Then we will actually get the mold created when we have finalized the product. And when the mold is made, we will again get samples about that. And what's happening internally here is what we have done with the Beckett Shield is every single samples have both been sent to Denmark and to our Dallas office. So we can see them, we can evaluate them all, we get feedback from the Dallas team with the graders and all these guys over there. And then we will give any feedback back to the manufacturing side. So roughly, I would say 4 or 5 samples before the mold are made. Then the mold are made, and then as we're doing on Dragon Steel, where we have a really tight quality control for every single production that goes, every single production days, they will send us samples that we test simply to ensure that the quality we have improved are maintained throughout a mass bulk production.
As someone who's been involved with product manufacturing where molds are involved, I know that the life expectancy of molds isn't indefinite. Have you guys been able to determine yet in it, you know, with the product and in its infancy, how long the life expectancy for the molds for Beckett Shield are?
No, not precise, but I would estimate they will last 5 years, depending on the volume we bring up on that mold. But I expect that we will add multiple molds of the same product down the line as the demand in the market is quite big. So I think we can afford it if we get a good piece of the market also.
Well, thank you for indulging me on that little nerd out moment there. I do find the manufacturing process absolutely fascinating. We've talked about the first wave of products. We alluded to a little bit on what to expect in the second wave with thicker card armors. Can you elaborate on additional products you foresee being released in the second wave?
Yeah, so in the first wave, we actually just included 9 pocket plates also. And we will include probably, as I mentioned, card armor in the different sizes. And after that, we do are looking at case holders for baseball and looking at where can we actually introduce new products that are not in the market. So unfortunately, I cannot tell too much about that. But
sure.
we are looking at in Q1, Q2, how can we go in and add extra value in the market for products that are not currently there. And that's something we put a great effort in on the Dragon Shield side is innovating in the market. How can we see a demand from the end users that they actually didn't even know they had for themselves before they see the product? And we hope to bring that over to the Dragon Shield line also.
Can you talk a little bit about the global business aspect of being located in Denmark, distribution in North America, as well as manufacturing in North America? Have there been any logistical challenges in the launch and rollout of the Beckett Shield that have been created because of the distance between the two or because of the modern era we're in that's just part of doing business?
So not, I wouldn't say because of the distance. I would say because of COVID, it is a little bit more complicated. We are very often in the States and visiting the Beckett guys on a normal basis if we don't have COVID. And Arcane Tinmen is doing worldwide distribution. So we have partners in China, Australia, entire Europe, North and South America. And we have manufacturing partners in Asia, we have them in Europe, and now we have a North American supply line also. So I would say that's normal business for our side. But of course, the COVID not being able to visit these manufacturers and see the beginning of the production and approve it face-to-face has been a little bit more difficult and a little bit more uncertain about can we meet the time we want. So we were all hoping that all our distributors in North America would have these products in their warehouse at this given time and be ready for full September release. But due to COVID, we have agreed with our distributor that the best thing to do is simply just releasing these products as they're getting in, and they'll start getting in at the end of September. And we have estimated the volume that the market in general will take. So hopefully we can meet demand based on the numbers our distributors have provided to us.
Yeah, I know a lot of collectors are really starved for product right now, so I hope you guys are ready. I know you are. But in talking, a lot of people I'm sure that are watching this have picked up on the aspect that there are some premium aspects to your product, which might initially create the sense that they're going to be significantly more than your competitors. But I wanted to give you an opportunity to talk about the pricing structures that you're bringing to the market.
Yes. Of course, we have kept our values from the Dragon Shield aspect, saying that we still provide high quality supplies for a collector. We have done it on the TCG side, and now we'll do it on the sports side also. About the pricing, we have always been told, especially from the Beckett side, that the sports side is more price sensitive. So what we have strived towards is being around the same price level as you already know from our competitors. So our product, we'll say 90% of our products are the same price level as you find by our competitors.
That's fantastic. Is there anything else while I've got you on the line that you think our viewers should know about Beckett Shield?
Well, the only thing I can mention here at the end is look forward to seeing the logo in stores. Hopefully, you can bring it up later in the show, because it's a beautiful logo. And what we have done there is we have taken the best from Beckett, where you have the big B, you have the leaf around that every sports collector will recognize. You're having a shield in the middle protecting the B, taken from Dragon Shield. So you have the best from the two worlds. To help every collector protect their most valuable cards.
It is a very nice logo. We talked about Beckett Shield in Hobby Happening segment last week, and it's certainly a beautiful logo. So you guys really knocked that one out of the park. Michael, I really appreciate you taking some time to talk with us. This is a much needed entry into the market, and I'm sure our viewers are going to be really excited to get their hands on the product. So thanks for joining us.
Well, thanks for having me.
All right.